Hi guys, welcome back to Eduet channel. Today we will be dealing with prion diseases. So what are prion diseases? Actually, they are the diseases or the disease which is caused by a protein. So we'll all be confused. Can a protein cause disease? Yeah, some proteins may misfold and they can cause a disease. So we'll be dealing with the disease. So, prion disease or transmissible spongiform encephalopathies are a family of rare progressive neurodegenerative disorder. That is, neurons will be degenerated. That is, breaking or breaking down of neurons. So, they'll be having the neuronal lesions, neuronal manifestations, neuronal loss, and a failure of inflammatory response. So, the causative agent are prions. Actually, the prion was termed by Stanley Prusiner in 1972 something, I think. And that prion is actually infectious protein, pro-in, that is in-pro, infectious in-protein, pro-in-pro was termed into prion. The words was rearranged. Now, the prion disease are also called transmissible spongiform encephalopathy. They are actually the abnormal folding of cellular proteins that are found mostly in the brain. The proteins in cells fold in an abnormal fashion that leads to the pathogenesis. The functions of these normal proteins are still not completely understood. So whenever they change the conformation, it can lead to the misfolded appearance that can lead to the disease, that is prion disease. So any species can get affected. So these are the occurrence of prion disease in different years in India. You can see it was most common in 1971 and in 1980 period. So this is the main area where the prion disease occur in India. In West Bengal and in Himachal Pradesh, Haryana border, we'll be getting more scrappy. And in Maharashtra, Karnataka and Kerala, we used to get VCJD. What is VCJD? Stay tuned, we'll be discussing it. So transmission in animals is actually due to the consumption of meat cum bone meal of infected animals. That is, lateral transmission is possible by taking bone meal or blood meal of infected animals. Both vertical and horizontal transmission are possible, but usually the vertical transmission is very less and horizontal transmission is more, I think. Not in Indian considering, in Indian scenario and in American scenario, it's usually horizontal. So genetic susceptibility of different indigenous sheep breeds of India to scrappy, that is the Malpura and Garol in West Bengal, is more the infection chance is high. So the mechanism of misfolding, this is the mechanism, that is endogenous protein will be turned into the misfolded protein. So this is the normal protein. You can see the normal protein here. Sometimes a misfold happens. A misfolding happens that can lead to PRPS. So the mechanism of misfolding is this. So the transmission is actually through the meat cum bone meal or blood meal, etc. Whenever the humans use meat products of infected animal, they also get. So this is the transmission and cycle in sheep. So the incubation period in humans is actually 39 to 55 years. It can take. It's very long because it's the neuronal degenerative disease. It's not an infectious disease like bacteria, virus, or any protozoa or any fungi, etc. So in animals, it usually takes 12 years. This is Stanley Prusiner. So these are the inflammatory response. This is classical scrapie, and whenever they get new host species, the prion strains may occur, and the drowsy gout or the scratching gout. Why it is known as drowsy gout or scratching gout? Because they produce extensive lesions in the brain. They produce extensive neurodegenerative lesions in the brain. This lead to the circling or the mad appearance, maddy appearance of the animal. So it may be showing many symptoms like rabies, They'll be having temporal twitches, they'll be having chorea, etc. So this is the introduction to environment and epidemiological reasons of this disease. So types in animals, that is scrapie, that is SC, is known as abbreviation is SC, that is mainly in sheep and goat. Transmissible mink, encephalopathy in mink, bovine spongiform encephalopathy, which was a very serious condition in the UK and America in the 1970s and 80s, actually in the cattle. Chronic wasting disease, CWD, it's in the, actually the forest animals. This is the mule, deer, elk, moose, etc. Feline spongiform encephalopathy, that's in the cat. So bovine spongiform encephalopathy, which is a very important disease caused by the prions. It is known as mad cow disease because they will be showing symptoms like a mad cow. They will be surfing, they will be pushing their head to the bricks and walls, etc. Actually, they get infected through the ingestion of infected flesh. Symptoms will be restlessness, aggressiveness, convulsions, self-mutilation, loss of appetite. You have to rule out rabies. This is the mad cow disease. So these are the clinical signs. They will be having paralysis, posterior paralysis and anterior paralysis. So this is the healthy cow brain under microscope. But see vacuolation happening. This is actually the bovine spongiform encephalopathy infected cow's brain tissue. This is scrapie. You can see so many vacuoles, so many gaps, etc. This is a normal tissue, brain tissue. This is kuru. This is classic CJD. Ataxia, hyperemia of the infected cow. Nervousness when confronted with obstacles. So this is paralysis of the cow. So moving to the sheep disease, that is scrapie, the disease of sheep and goats. They'll be having itching symptoms and they'll be rubbing their skin towards any hard objects. This can cause bleeding. This can cause secondary bacterial infection, etc. So this is the loss of wool or due to the itching behavior. So this is the neuronal manifestation. Actually, the neuronal manifestation seen in the sheep. See, the wools are getting lost. So in types in human, this is a zoonotic disease. Actually, it's not zoonotic, but it can transfer from animal to human beings. So sporadic Jacob Creutzfeldt disease, that is CJD or JCD. And sometimes it's genetic, that is, it can occur from the genetic imbalances. Also, the acquired disease is known as kuru, that is very famous. So the clinical signs of human infections. So this is the CJD disease. Risk of CJD is low and their associated symptoms are personality changes. It's actually like the brain lesion. So we'll be having classic forms and other forms. You'll be having thinking problem, impaired judgment, insomnia, memory disorders, depressions, etc. Brain shrinkage and deterioration occurs rapidly. Brain section are showing spongiform encephalopathy. So this is the human prion diseases, CJD, variant CJD, kuru, fetal, familial, insomnia. These are the brain lesions. Animal prion diseases are mainly BSC, CWD, scrapie, transmissible mink encephalopathy and feline spongiform encephalopathy. So these are the bovine spongiform encephalopathy and chronic wasting disease. CWD is actually present in the deer, elk, moose in the North America and South Korea, etc. BSC is present in America, United Kingdom, etc. So these are the comparison between the animal prion disease and human prion diseases. So the microscopic lesions will be vacuole formation and spongiform changes in the brain. So you can one can easily identify the vacuolar formation and the destruction of brain macrophages, etc. in the microscopic lesions. So see, you can see extensive vacuolation present. Spongiform change in prion disease. This is actually the vacuolation. See. Vacuoles. Spongiform change. So you can see a video of an animal having scrapie. See, it's having tremor-like lesions, minor tremor, head tremor. Loss of sensation. Yeah, absence of menace response. It's having no response. So you'll be having lip movement, positive scratch test, and all. So the diagnosis is actually not confirmed. The diagnosis, you don't have any gold standard test. You can see by the clinical symptoms, clinical lesions, and also by blood profile analysis and brain tissue analysis. So process to be disinfected in the prion contaminated materials. They should be dipped in one normal sodium hypochlorite. High-risk material are brain, spinal cord, posterior eye, pituitary tissue, etc. No-risk materials are blood. But blood meal can cause the disease. So, if you are familiar with this video and you got to understand the topics, then answer these questions and check your response. Thank you.